Hey guys, welcome back again. So in this video, let's talk something more about Mongoose. So currently inside our app.js file where we are making a database connection, here we are calling mongoose.connect and we are passing in the URI and then we are having this thin block. But here inside my MongoDB Atlas, what I have done that I have removed network access of my MongoDB cluster from anywhere because I have not provided any IP address here. That is, we do not have any whitelist IP address through which any application can connect. So let's go back to our application and here let me start this application and let's see what error do we get here. And we have to wait for a couple of seconds. And we see here that we are getting this error here. That is unhandled promise rejection warning. And it is a MongoDB timeout error and server selection timeout after 30 seconds here. And that is because we are not catching this error. So what we need to do, we need to make a catch clause here and we should say catch. And then we have the error. And then what we can simply do, we can simply log in the error. So console log error.message like this. And now we can save this application and we won't be having this promise rejection warning. So let's save this application again. And now after 30 seconds or so, we would see this catch block here that it would catch the error that is thrown by Mongoose connection here and that would contain the error message here inside the console. So let's wait for a couple of seconds more and most likely we are going to see that error here. So we see that we are not getting unhandled promise rejection warning anymore, but we are getting this error message here that is server selection timed out after 30,000 milliseconds. So now what I'll do, I'll go to my Atlas here and here I'll provide in the whitelist entry. And currently I'll allow it from anywhere and let's save it by clicking confirm here. And now I'll be able to connect to this cluster from anywhere. So now let's save this application again. And this time we'll be able to see this message that is MongoDB connected. So let's try to save it again. And we see that we are getting this message here that is MongoDB connected. And this is how you should catch your errors when you are using mongoose.connect. And there are some more Mongoose connection events that are published whenever this connection happens. So those events are called connected, that whenever the Mongoose connection is connected or if there is an error in connection or if the connection is disconnected. So how do we handle those events? So it is very easy to handle them. So what we can do, we can simply say mongoose.connection.on and here the first event would be connected. So it is the connected event. And then it fires a callback function and here we can simply log in inside the console that Mongoose is connected. So Mongoose connected to database like this. And then we have some more events. So what we can do, we can again say mongoose.connection.on. You can use on or once. If you use on, then that event will be fired every time. But if you use it once, then that event would be fired only once. So I'm going to use here on like this. And then another event would be an error event in case some error happens. So it would be an error event like this. And then the callback function takes in one parameter and that is the error here like this. And then we can simply log in the error to the console. So error.message like this. And then we have a disconnected event that whenever your Mongoose connection is disconnected. So we can say mongoose.connection.on disconnected. Then we again have a callback function and here we can simply log here again that Mongoose connection is disconnected. Connection is disconnected like this. So now if we save our application, so most likely we'll be seeing these events here. So let's save this application again. And we see that we are getting these events here. That is Mongoose connected to DB. So this is from this event here, that is Mongoose connected to DB. And it is because of the connected event. And we are not getting this error message because there was no error. But now once we close this application, we should be able to see this disconnected event here. So let's close this application by pressing Ctrl C. And we are not seeing this event, disconnected event. And that is because we have forced disconnected our Mongoose connection and we have not properly shut down our Mongoose connection, and that is because we should manually close our database connection. And how to do that? That is pretty simple. So there are some events that are fired when the application is terminated by pressing Ctrl+C, and you can handle that inside Node.js like this. So process.on, and it should be second like this. This event is fired when the application is terminated by pressing Ctrl+C, and we can see that by logging it inside the console. So console log, and we can simply say 123. And then to close the application manually, what we need to do, if you leave it like this, then the application would not be terminated. And to terminate the application, what you need to do, you should simply call this thing here, that is process.exit. And here you should pass in the exit status code, and typically you should pass in here 0 to terminate your application. And now let's save this application, and now let's start this application again. And now everything is started as Mongoose is connected. And now let's press Ctrl+C, and if we press Ctrl+C, we'll be seeing this log statement here, that is 123. So let's press Ctrl+C to terminate the application, and we see that we are getting here 123. And now here, whenever you terminate your application, then you should close the Mongoose connection, and then this event would be fired. That is, the Mongoose disconnected event would be fired, and that would be done before this process.exit thing here. So let me remove this log statement from here. And here what you should do, you should simply do mongoose.connection.close, and then it takes back in a callback function here. And here you can console log something, that is Mongoose default connection is disconnected. So Mongoose connection is disconnected due to app termination. And this thing, that is, you should terminate your application only when the connection is closed. So we can move this thing from here inside this connection.close thing here, because this callback function is fired only when the connection to the Mongoose database is been closed. So let's save this application again. And now let's try to start our application again. And once we terminate this application by pressing Ctrl+C, this event, that is process.onSegent, would be fired. And due to this event, this callback function would be called, and then it will close the Mongoose connection. And once it closes the Mongoose connection, this console log statement we are going to see in the console. And then finally, we are going to see this thing inside the console, that is, the connection is disconnected. So now let's press Ctrl+C and let's see. So here we see that after pressing Ctrl+C, we see that we are getting this thing here, that is Mongoose connection is disconnected, because we have disconnected that connection here, and we are getting this thing because of this thing here. And then finally, we are getting this console log statement, and that is due to this statement, console log statement this. And then finally, we terminated our application using this process.exit and with status code of 0. So this is how you should properly handle your Mongoose connections. And as we can see here, that our app.js file is becoming too huge, because we are handling all the Mongoose events here inside the app.js file. But what we should do is that we should create a new file here that should be called init database. So let's call that file init db.js like this. And this should be in the root folder and not in the routes folder. And now inside this init.db file, what I'll do, I'll export this function here. And I can export this function like this. So module.exports equal to function, an arrow function here. And here inside this function, I'll copy all this logic from here, that is from the app.js file. So I'll copy all this logic from here up till the mongoose.connect thing here, and I'll remove it from the app.js file, and I'll paste it here inside this function. And now here, since we are using Mongoose here, we need to require Mongoose here at the very top. So since we are not using Mongoose here inside the app.js file, we can remove it from here, and we can paste it here inside the initdb.js file. And now we can save this file from here, and now we can go back to our app.js file. So here inside the app.js file, what we can do, we can simply make a comment here, that is initialize db like this. And then we should require that function from the initdb file. So we can do something like this, that is initdb, And then we need to directly invoke this function. That is this function here. And we are executing that function inside the app.js file. So now let's save this rapp.js file here. And now let's start the application again. And now if everything is fine, then our application would again be working. So now we see that Mongoose is connected to DB, MongoDB connected. And now let's press Ctrl C to stop the application. And we see that we are getting those events also, that the Mongoose connection is disconnected and Mongoose connection is disconnected due to app termination. And doing this makes our app.js file much cleaner than it was before by putting all the database related stuff inside this initdb.js file. So guys, that's all about this video. So see you in the next one.